Pop Spotlight, brought to you by Dragon's Lair Comics and Fantasy. Hey everyone, I'm Adam Harry from Bella Souls with
Evan from Dragon's Lair Comics and Fantasy.
And we're back with another Tabletop Spotlight. Evan, what is this one?
This is Pirate Tunes from Stronghold Games.
Pirates.
It's a fun little game. The artwork's cool. It's easy to go. It's fun.
Cool. What's obviously pirates? What are we doing in this game?
Yeah, so you're building your own pirate ship, and you're going to build the best pirate ship.
Well,
and,
obviously, yeah.
Whoever builds the best pirate ship wins. So
I feel like there's going to be some booty involved in this.
Yes,
game.
There are. Like there's a booty. Chest full of booty. Nice. And yes,
Pirate Tunes. All right, cool. Let's take a look inside the box. Pirate Tunes.
Pirate Tunes.
You ready for this one, man? We are. Oh, we cheated a little bit. We took the plastic wrap off already, so
it's ready to go.
So we can do this. Open this one.
I like the artwork on the box. It's literally a chest.
Actually, we didn't show the black kind of bottom off.
Let's put it back. There we go. This is the back.
That's the back of the box, as you can see. Lots of cool stuff.
Yeah, layout of the game.
It looks like there's going to be the shipbuilding aspect
from
the center point there. So.
Yes. Yeah. Awesome.
Cool. All right, that was the back of the box. Now we can get to work. All right, here we go. I do like the artwork. It's kind of that goofy, kind of fun.
Meeples.
Oh!
Get a little bag of meeples.
Always need more meeples, right?
Technically, they're pirates.
Pirate meeples.
Pirate meeples.
There you go.
Preeples.
We got extra bags. Yes. We always appreciate these.
Very good. Yes.
That's very appreciated. Thank you.
Don't have to go to your grocery store and get more.
Right.
So this is the rulebook.
We'll come back to that.
Yeah, too. Only a few pages, but we'll come back to it.
Full color look like, but yeah, we'll go back to it.
Yes.
Oh, we have.
They used special gunpowder black sand for their minute counter.
Nice.
Like that. Yeah, it's a cool touch.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's shiny.
And then
there's
we've
minerals
got
in
this.
There.
Okay, so. This is the chest. Actually, it's bound together.
Let's
so
keep. Oh, you work on that one.
Okay.
You talk about that
these
one.
These are together.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Hang on. Oh, that's a cool looking inside of the box too. That's a nice touch. I like that.
Nice touch.
All right. Move this. What do we
got? Give me this top part right here.
This top part.
Yes.
Check.
So these actually go together, and you can tell right here.
There's
a little. Yeah. There's a little edge here, so you can put stuff inside.
Okay.
This is the chest. So what you do is you're gonna put the pieces in there. You're gonna put the top of the chest on. And you're putting the pieces upside down. Put the top of the chest on, and you flip it over, and when you open the chest, the pieces are gonna be right side up. So that's a cool aspect of the game. And these are, of course, the pieces.
So those are randomized, and then
So you're gonna put
face down.
You're gonna put them down random, face down, you're gonna put them down, and then you put the lid on, flip it over, take the lid off the chest, and then you can reveal the treasure or the pieces to put your ships together. So
okay, that's a cool touch.
It's a very cool aspect.
All right, I'm gonna slide these out a couple of.
Yeah, let's do it. All
right, pull those out.
So these are quick, just like turn guides. So they show you like the turn you can go and whatnot, and the basic the point system is on the back as well. So
okay, it's a little cheat sheet for
so
you.
Each player gets one. It's just a little cheat sheet
and lots of tokens.
Yes,
I like the tokens.
And then of course up top. On these as well are points. So these are the points.
Okay. And then these look like ship building
parts. So each ship, so these are the strips.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, these are the strips. And they're actually, if we go back to the chest, they're gonna
be
laid face down in these three spots.
And then
these if you flip these back over, are pieces that go on top. So you can get the pirate or the wheel for the ship. You can get people
crew.
More crew here. Flags,
very important.
Add speed to your ship. So there's also that aspect.
Okay. And it looks like there's different levels.
Yes, so there's, I think, four different levels. And it's signaled by these barrels. So one level is one barrel and so far. And you can get more points based on how tall your ship is and stuff like that.
Okay.
Those are add-ons.
Some ships there, and then we've got more.
Yeah, so each player starts off with stern and a bow for the back?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is one of them. This is a starting off ship. That's what you start off with.
Okay.
And then these are just
more tokens, points, and coins.
And then these are what you put on top of the ship and stuff
and
like that.
And again, same kind of design in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Seen that. And then
another starter ship. This is like the mermaid one. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Oh, the ships are actually different.
Yeah,
so there's
basically different.
The blue player has this, the green player, I guess, has the mermaid.
Yeah, yes. And they'll have different startings, so you can,
All right. Oh, this one's a dragon.
Yeah, that's dragon cool. one. That's my favorite.
That's your favorite?
Yeah.
What would you call that ship?
And then there's that one.
Whoa, it's like a mechanical
crocodile. If orcs were pirates, that would be it.
It's got teeth, dog. And then again, same designs.
Same
so
design.
Aesthetically, it's all same. And then these are more
add-ons,
sections, more flags.
Yes,
very cool. Same stuff there. More ships and flags.
Yep.
They have different flags. I guess it's the flags could also be. Does it matter?
It doesn't matter what the design on the flag is. It's just the fact that they're
okay.
A flag. Yeah.
Okay. So you can have whatever, yeah. Just orc eyeball thing in mm-hmm.
there. Definitely.
Okay, so there's that one and that one.
Yep.
All right, so and these are all level ones. And yeah, so it's just twos yeah. and threes and fours.
And since it's randomized, you don't know what level you're gonna get. But okay. Once we go over the rules, we can talk about yeah. how many points.
So this looks pretty cool that you're gonna randomize all these with yes. the treasure chest mechanic, and yes. I guess you're gonna take turns grabbing stuff.
Yes, and we can go over that here.
Cool. Well, yeah, let's. This sounds pretty cool already. Let's go ahead and take a look in the rule book there. Okay, we have the rule book out. It's really not very difficult at all. It's just a really simple game.
Yeah, and the rules themselves, the book itself, is not very many.
Yeah, we're talking. Six pages, eight pages total. With the yeah. front and back. So, but basically all you're doing, there's the typical play area. It's up to four players.
Yes.
You've got the little stacks, and we were talking about these stacks. There's a set number of turns, basically.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
of the number of stacks.
Mm-hmm.
And the planks as well. So that's, it kind of keeps the game quick and fast.
Yes.
It's kind of a neat game because it's got a bit of a bidding mechanic.
Yeah, it's got a bit of a bidding mechanic, and you also want to plan ahead and kind of a building mechanic. So you have to
okay.
figure out what you're going to be doing with your ship.
Okay, cool. And then again, the phases are real quick. I think there's six phases total in the game, but they're yes. super fast.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jerstron, setting up the treasure chest is more important, really. But
yeah, mm-hmm.
as you see here, I mean the rules. It's a little hard to read, obviously, with the camera, but the artwork is nice in the book. It's
yeah.
it's designed to be played real quick. The scoring sheet's real simple and easy to follow.
Yes.
So it's yeah. actually really well done.
And there's so many ways you can get points, too. Yes. Like, it's not just one goal. You can do several things to get more points.
Right, so you're not going to get knocked out of the game if you yeah. screw up initially.
However, there's also so many ways you can lose points.
Bingo.
So also another thing to look out for.
So, real quick, why don't we show off the treasure thing? It kind of makes more sense when you see it kind of in action. So
right, so this is the treasure chest. It'll be in the middle of the board. And we'll take the pieces this size, and we'll put them on
again.
Upside
there's
down.
Six stacks, and yeah. you'd put one on each.
Exactly, and there's 24 total of these, so there's gonna be technically six phases of those.
Right.
And we'll put everything face down on the board.
Yeah.
Then the leader, which it just everyone takes.
And those
turns.
Are all random too. They're face down. You don't.
Yeah.
Know what
face
they
down.
Are.
You don't know what they are. They're gonna be completely random. Put the lid on. Flip it over, not like that, because they'll spill out of you. And then you lift it up, and then you can see everything.
Yeah, and again, ideally those would all line up, and now they're face up.
Right.
So yes. what do we do now?
So now, what we do is we'll take our pirates, our meeples, and we will invest. So starting with the leader, he will put his meeple on whatever he wants. Let's say I, as the green player, want this strip right here for my ship.
So whatever that strip was, right. you really want that one.
So I'm going to place a meeple there, a pirate there.
And then I would go and I would say, I want this right there.
Right there. And let's say I don't want him to get this, so I'm just going to invest another one just in case. In case yeah. I'm gonna put it. Let's say we finish.
And we just
and
keep going through and say we end up something like that.
Like that. So
you have one extra?
I have one extra. And we'll go over that in a second. So in this case, I would get that one, nobody gets this one, and then you get this one and these two.
Right.
So just take our meeples off.
Take your meeples off.
Both of us left over. Yeah, both of us left over had one. So what we do with these one is we get unemployment pay, which means we get a coin for each one that we had left over. So we'd each get one coin.
Boom.
Then, for whatever's left over on this board, because remember we didn't get that or a couple
yeah,
others.
Yeah, there's a couple mm-hmm. leftover ones.
We will do a bidding. So we'll put as many coins as we want to bid in our hands. So I'm going to put, let's say I put two in my hands and he puts one.
Yep.
We go out and we flip over. Whoever has the most coins gets to choose first, and it will just go in order.
Yeah. You start the game with three coins, too.
Yes, yeah.
You start so you have a little reserve to go with.
And that's how you do the bidding. That's how you get everything off the board. After that, it's just building your ship and trying to do what you need to do to win the game.
Yep. So every turn, all of the pieces will get removed and placed onto mm-hmm. somebody's ship.
Yep. And every turn, the leader will
reset everything,
put the pieces down, flip it, and everything like that. So it's very,
keep going.
Very simple game.
It's fun, too, because it's got that little kinetic thing of you know, actually flipping the board.
Yeah, and you could say, all right, I'm opening the chest now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's a fun
really dramatically.
Aesthetic, yeah. It's really cool.
And of course, you got the wooden meeples too, so that's
yes.
always a good session.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like a really fun little game.
Yep.
Let's hop out for a really quick recap. Pirate Tunes.
Yes.
We're going to crunch numbers again from Stronghold Games.
Yeah, Stronghold Games. The price is going to be $49.95. So
not
it's about
bad.
An average price for a board game this size.
We're talking what, like 8 and up on this one?
Yeah, we're around 2 to 4 players, and okay. it usually lasts around 30 minutes. So
yeah.
It's not even that long.
Wow,
of a game.
Yeah. So yeah. super quick.
Yeah, it's a nice game you can play over and over again. So
lots
nice.
Of replay value there
yeah.
too. So
mm-hmm.
yeah, it'd be an awesome game, family game night.
Yeah,
or
it's a good family
on
game.
Saturday.
Not heavy material, so
yeah, good. It's yeah. fun times. You're building a pirate ship, and you
yeah, right.
Come on, it's a good time. Well, I'm Adam Harry from Bell Souls.
I'm Evan from Dragon's Lair Comics Fantasy,
and this has been another Tabletop Spotlight. Thanks again for watching. Tabletop Spotlight, brought to you by Dragon's Lair Comics and Fantasy. Thanks for watching.